gang, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Well, you guys got a wake-up call this morning there in Southern California at 9:46 Pacific Standard Time. There was a magnitude 4.1 earthquake that so far 5,123 people said they felt. Intensity level of 5, and this was a thrust earthquake. Actually, a reverse thrust earthquake where one fault line rises up over the other one. Similar to what happened yesterday by the Kermadec Islands that I reported. Yeah, the fault actually ruptured quite a ways. You know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. This earthquake was picked up over 1,000 miles away. I'll bring it over and show you. The rupture distance, you can see it at the bottom there. We got the miles also listed at the bottom. Yeah, this was a very significant earthquake. There's been a lot of aftershocks. Let me bring this up a little bit. And I'm going to go back another 4 hours on this. And I'll have to, we got a small foreshock. Let me go back another 2 hours so I can bring that earthquake in. And I'm going to measure this to see exactly if it really was a 4.1. All right, so I'm using Swarm. And here's the signature, the seismic signature. Oh, man, the spectrogram isn't working. That's all right. There it is. Look at that. It's like, oh. All right, let's see. No, it was larger than what they're saying. I get a 4.22, and I shortened the seismic signature because the rupture was so long. It actually was probably a magnitude 4.48. All right, now I'm getting the spectrogram for this earthquake. I don't know why at first it wasn't working, but we got some smaller ones afterwards. That's probably rock slides. I bet you those are rock slides. Another rock slide. See how it's at the top? Yeah. And another rock slide. Some of the reports on EMSC. Long, strong shake. Boom. Seemed pretty intense for a 4.1, but we are pretty close to the epicenter. I was standing, and it was difficult to walk. About 2 seconds of shake they felt there. Heard it coming, and then a bang right under us. Very loud, strong boom and jolt. Shook the whole house. One of the hardest felt, definitely loudest. Rumbled for 10 seconds afterwards. Paradise Mountain. Heard it coming first, then a large shake with a boom. Yeah, that fault ruptured. You should be prepared. You might have a larger one coming. Valley Center. Initial rumble, then brief, intense, 2 to 3 second shake. 5 to 10 totals. I wonder if they're talking about the smaller shakes. Started as a slow, quiet rumble, then progressed with the rumble getting louder. Thought it might be a big truck going by, and then the rumble noise peaked in with a loud boom and started rolling away. Yeah, let's take a look at this. This is from the only monitor that I have close by. I'll bring it over for you. You see a small shake there at the end. Two small shakes there. We'll go ahead another 4 hours. Yeah, they got another one that just happened. Yeah, it came from Palomar Mountain. That's the only one that I got. You know, I've talked about how you guys should be ready for a large earthquake because of all the activity that was happening down there in the Gulf of California. And how the seismic pressure was moving up in this area. There's the Salton Sea. Yeah, a bit of excitement for you guys. So let's bring it out. I want to look at the fault. Let's see. Yeah, we got a locked blocked area right there. I did that in one of my other reports. Those that follow me will remember. Yeah, we got the Elsinore Fault going up towards Whittier. See, and these are all extensions of the St. Andreas Fault. Yeah. So did you feel it? Did you have damage? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.